Welcome to OSIsoft's video playlist covering a Pi Server installation walkthrough. Before we start installing the Pi Server, we'll take the time in this video to plan out our installation and ensure that we've met the minimum hardware and software requirements. Doing these things requires that we have a brief understanding of what the Pi Server consists of and how its components layer on top of each other. So let's consult OSIsoft's live library to get a good understanding for the Pi system for the rest of the installation process. Here I'll navigate to livelibrary.osisoft.com, where I'll find the Pi Server documentation, and then I'll select the appropriate version, and I'll drill down through the Pi Server installation, the Pi Data Archive installation, then the Welcome section, and under Overview, we'll find the Pi System components. And we'll see here that the Pi System is comprised up of one or more interface nodes collecting data from data sources, which then in turn gets sent to the Pi Data Archive / Pi AF server, which collectively will make up the Pi server. The data will then get sent to the client PC. So now that we know that the Pi server consists of the Pi Data Archive and the Pi AF server, let's look at how these components will interact during the installation process. So like I said, the Pi server is comprised up of two components, the AF server and the Data Archive. Now to install a Data Archive, there has to be an AF server available on the network, and the AF server itself is comprised up of two components, the AF SQL database and the AF service. The AF service will require an AF SQL database, which will require a Microsoft SQL Server to be installed on the network. So from a fresh installation, the order of installation will be 1. Install a Microsoft SQL Server on the network if you don't already have one. And then 2. You can install the AF server. And then 3. Finally, we'll install the Data Archive. So as you can see with these three components, there's a lot of different valid network architectures that will accommodate all three pieces. So let's take a look at the most common examples. Here in the Pi System and SQL Server configuration options, we will see a couple different configurations. The first one being the small Pi system. This is for systems with fewer than 10,000 assets and fewer than 25,000 Pi points. So this is the architecture that we'll be installing in this video walkthrough series. And here in the network diagram, we can see that it consists of a Pi Data Archive, an AF server, and the SQL Server all on the same node. And we're using the SQL Server license Express. For larger systems with more than 10,000 assets or more than 25,000 points, we'll use a larger, higher performance Pi system. And we can see here that it involves the Data Archive on its own dedicated hardware, or even a collection of hardware, and then an AF server and a SQL database on a separate machine. This will use the standard or enterprise SQL Server license. We also have distributed, highly available Pi systems. This configuration will be for high performance or specialized systems that require network load balancing and redundancy. This will also require a standard or enterprise SQL Server license. So the perfect architecture for you might not be in this list, but these are good places to start. Next, we'll look at the Install a Pi Data Archive server and start the pre-installation process. Now here, the procedure will start with determining the operating system requirements. So we'll click here and open the System Requirements section, where we'll see that the Windows Server 2012 R2 that I intend to use is listed here, so that's fine. And scrolling down, the AF server requirements will be in the Pi AF installation guide or the AF release notes. So I've already downloaded those, so let's go see what the AF server requires. Here in my Pi install folder, my release notes, and then down in the setup section, we can see that Windows Server 2012 R2 will be a valid operating system. And I'll be able to use my SQL Server 2012 Express Edition, so that's fine. But to install the AF server, I'll also need an AF database. And the AF database will be created by this AFSQL script execution feature. We'll see here that in order for the AF database to be installed, this AFSQL script execution feature has to run when we run the AF install kit. So we have to run this in AF install kit as an account with a sysadmin connection to the SQL server. So this is another important requirement of our Pi installation process. We'll come back into our Pi server guide and then determine the disk volumes for our deployment. So OSIsoft will recommend that you have 5 disks for your Pi server. One for the operating system, one for your Pi root directory, one for your Pi archives, one for your event queue, and finally one for backups. Here, back in my computer, we'll see that I already have these 5 set up for me, and I've even named them appropriately depending on what I expect these drives to be used for. Next, we will go to the Download Pi Data Archive Resource Files and Setup Kit section, where we'll see the Find Hardware and System Size Requirements spreadsheet. This spreadsheet will ask for things like how many Pi points you expect to have and what your expected data rates are. And it'll output how big your Pi server should be based on its processor speed, how much storage space it should have, and how much RAM it should have. I've already ran this spreadsheet and sized my machine appropriately, so we'll move to the next section in the pre-installation phase. I'm going to install the PyAF server in a later video, so we'll skip ahead to 5 where we record the data archive server name. Luckily, mine is written here on my desktop, so I know that it's PySRV 2016. Step 6 will ensure that the port 5450 is open. So this will link to a KB that will describe all of the network ports that have to be open for the Pi server to communicate with the rest of the Pi system. So you can open that KB and either set up the firewall rules yourself or send it to IT. Next, we'll ensure that the proper permission levels for installation. So we already know that we need sysadmin to install the AFSQL database on the SQL server, but we also need local administrator on the machine that we're installing the software. So what we'll do is we'll search for computer management, where we'll look at our local users and groups and check to make sure that we're in the administrators group. So this here is my personal account. So this means I'm a local administrator, so I should have no problems running the install kits. Next, we'll synchronize the time settings on our Pi system computers. Since all of my components are going to be on the same machine, synchronize doesn't really make sense, but I'll come into the date and time settings and make sure that the time zone and the time is configured appropriately. Next, we will disable the Windows time zone environment variable. Mine came this way by default, but if you're not sure if yours is or not, follow the steps in step 9, depending on what operating system you're using. So the last 2 steps will involve creating a machine signature file and then using that machine signature file to generate a license file. So I'll do this as part of the installation process in a later video. So that means the last thing to do is actually download our install kits. So here, navigating to techsupport.osisoft.com, we'll start our downloads. So after logging in, we'll choose the data archive downloads. And then the install kit we want is this Pi Data Archive 2016 install kit. So we'll click here and then follow the instructions to get the kits downloaded. I've already done this, so I'm going to move ahead to the AF section. Here we'll download our Pi Asset Framework Pi AF Server 2016 install kit. as well as the SQL Server Express 2012 with tools, if we don't already have one on the network. And then we'll download our Py Analysis Service 2016 install kit. This will allow us to run calculations with our elements and attributes. Now, the Py documentation is available on the live library, but to get the SQL Server Express white paper, we'll come down to the bottom of the page here, and in white papers, we'll download the SQL Server 2012 Express for Py Server white paper, and this will guide us through the installation process for our SQL Server. So now, once we have all our kits downloaded here in the Py install folder, and we've confirmed our access permissions and system specifications, we're ready to begin installing our Py server. The first step will be to install the SQL server to host the AF database, and that's going to be in the next video in the series. If you've already done that installation, or already have a SQL server that you intend to use, you can skip ahead to the Install a New Py Server 2016 full walkthrough video. And in that video, we'll install the Py AF server, and then the Py data archive.